Everyone who ever lived here falls victim to some tragedy. Like her daughter a year ago.
My daughter was my whole life. To hear her voice again, I would give all I have.
If someone wants to be heard, we are here.
For once in your life, admit that you are up against something bigger than you.
Tonight, we are all afraid. We cannot hide from our ghosts.
Hello. My name is Michael Morley, and I am here to review A Haunting in Venice. Starring and returning Kenneth Branagh as the investigator Poirot, who you may have seen in other adaptations, as in Murder on the Orient Express and Death on the Nile. A Haunting in Venice, this is actually the first live movie adaptation. The other two were actually reboots. So this is actually the first one in the franchise that is not a reboot. There was a TV movie, but that was a TV movie. It wasn't a live theatrical adaptation. So this is actually a new thing. And, you know, I've watched Midnight on the Orient Express and I've watched Death on the Nile. They're not bad, you know, little movies. They're not bad whodunit. I love these sort of movies. It's like a Cluedo. It's like, you know, Knives Out. It's more old-fashioned, you know, back in time, in the 30s and the 40s. I love that era. This is set in 1947. And I love that it questions faith and you know, hauntings and you know, seance and psychics, and you know, obviously investigator Poirot does not believe in any of this stuff. He thinks this is all tricks, this is all a hoax. It's a very clever movie with lots of twists and turns. It's different to the first two. You know, there's a different twist in this one. It's very cool. It's actually, you know, if you love these sort of movies of whodunit, I think you're going to like this. It's very old-fashioned. He goes into a house, is full of orphans who have a party. It's set in Halloween. And, you know, there's a Michelle Yeoh plays the psychic, and she is fantastic in the movie. And Tina Fey is in this movie, and this is a different role for her. Instead of her playing the comedic, you know, plucky comic relief, she actually gets to play something serious. And it's a different tone for her, and it's great. I love that when I see comedic actors break into serious acting. It's just a good thing to see. Jamie Dornan is in this movie, who you may know from 50 Shades of Grey. He's great. He's very good in this movie. I actually like him more in this movie than I do in 50 Shades of Grey. I feel like that franchise did him no justice whatsoever. And this movie is good, and he does a good performance in it. There's a kid in the movie. He is fantastic. This little boy who plays his son. Great actor. Great actor. There are other supporting actors. They're all fantastic. They all play a good part, and they all have something that adds to this film. And you're kind of like, who is it? You know, you kind of jumble around like who it could be. The investigator is so clever how he's able to notice these things and put it all together. And I gotta say, I think these sort of movies are dying. I feel like we are losing these type of movies, and when we need to support them. I really feel like I would love to see more of these sort of movies, and I would love to see another film with Kenneth Branagh returning as Investigator Poirot, because I really feel like this movie might not make as much money, simply because it was just me and two other people that were here in the room tonight that I saw the movie with. And I might be wrong, but I recommend seeing this movie if you're into the if you're into this type of genre. 8 out of 10. Great time.
We cannot hide from our ghosts. Whether they are real or not.